that is knowledge, I think, even without experience.
That's right.
Yeah, and I would like to stress again that we are talking about transferring knowledge from one person to another, but not ability to generate new knowledge, because you cannot, after transferring, even 10% be as Einstein. It's absolutely obvious. Okay, let's continue our topic. It's how to capture tacit knowledge. Of course, David already made excellent presentation, and his focus was that most efficient way of capturing tacit knowledge. It's just transferring knowledge from one person to another. During transferring or working together, definitely knowledge could be transferred not only which can be transferred to explicit knowledge, in documented, but also some knowledge which can be transferred during working together, so-called, for example, on-job training. I will talk in my presentation based on my real practical experience, because I was involved in this process. We tried. This is not so easy on many nuclear organizations in different countries. I was involved in Ukraine, in Russia on nuclear power plants, and in Bulgaria on Kozloduy. This is just a real, how to say, I would like to share with you my practical view, what lesson I learned, what problem could be, and how it's better to establish procedure of capturing knowledge. And I will talk again, it's according to definition even of IAEA, that capturing knowledge to knowledge base of organization. It means transferring knowledge, and it should be documented. I will not talk about transferring knowledge from one person to another person. I would you can read the second statement. This is a real procedure or process how we can set up maybe a short, small project or just procedure, because on nuclear power plants normally, because it's based on procedures, it should be officially approved, this procedure of capturing knowledge from expert. It means main steps is to use right or most efficient and effective method and tools, how to find a facilitator, how to find another expert who can understand and ask right question and can after that record and to transfer knowledge, tacit knowledge to knowledge database, and of course to define who else can be participated in this process. Of course, most important that at least for nuclear power plants, that some knowledge should be available for other people. And the most efficient way is to put it in special process, if it is possible. It's one of the methods. It was already mentioned many times that we are not able and not necessary to capture all knowledge what expert has. Quite important at the beginning to make some prioritization, to put a list with priorities, which knowledge is really critical, after that, which knowledge is very important and may be unique, because sometimes we are working in dynamical area, and sometimes knowledge is unique, but at this moment is not critical, but something could happen, and this knowledge can be can become as critical knowledge. How to identify critical knowledge? Tomorrow, I think it will be a special exercise, self-assessment tools, not self-assessment tool, a practical session or knowledge loss risk assessment. This is very efficient and procedure, and it can be used as first step to identify critical knowledge in experts. We should understand, because in many organizations, sometimes we have brilliant people with high level of performance, but they just can do a lot, but they have, but their position and their knowledge is not critical for mission of organization. We should differentiate and not confused with this problem. Don't mix critical knowledge with high performance. This is just example what we did in my organization. This is so method I will describe again a little bit later, card sorting, when we identify first of all with expert all critical and knowledge which is necessary for right and efficient operation of organization, and after that people, and try to create links between this person and necessary competences or critical knowledge, and after that we immediately can identify who owner of critical knowledge, and after that we can start working with this expert individually. And by the way, you know that working with people is very interesting. And sometimes during identification of nuclear knowledge, we can realize, we can find another very important information, how to optimize some processes, how to optimize performance, some division, or even organization as a whole. It's also quite important. Normally, when we should start working with expert, we should start with first step. And very easy advice is just to use as first step so-called 5W and H approach. What does it mean? It's 5W, it means what, who, when, where, and why. And H, it's how. It means already it was mentioned several times that knowledge management working with three directions. Knowledge, know what, know how, and know why. But when we are working with expert, sometimes, not sometimes, always, we should think not about static knowledge. What should be done, how it should be done, why we are doing. We also should see environment with whom person is working. We should think about some phases of some processes. It means when some action should be done, what is most important at concrete time do. And of course, quite important, at least for people who is working with repairing, with maintenance, it's a question know where. It means where to find information, where to find some spare parts, and so on. This is very, very easy, very simple, but a start, it's very, very effective. Capturing critical knowledge, again. It was mentioned already that it's impossible and not necessary to capture all knowledge. And I know about myself that I, together with knowledge in my brain, I have a lot of waste. And that is why not necessary even to talk on some topics. We should also understand that real expert is too busy, because it's, he or she is very valuable for organization, and he or she participate in many project and activities. That is why when we start, when we plan activity to capture knowledge, we should be very good prepared. And some expert is very, very closed and not easy even to talk with them. We should also understand that sometimes one expert could be replaced with several experts. And knowledge is not now knowledge has quite limited time, and in 5-10 years, this knowledge will be already not unique and maybe not even critical. Requirements for technique of knowledge capturing. Of course, we need normally facilitator, and I play several times role of facilitator, and sometimes it's not easy role. Of course, we should focus on essential, critical, or unique knowledge. We should try to use expert face-to-face on short period of time. It means that if it's possible, sometimes we should ask him maybe to fill out some questionnaire when he or she has enough time. And quite important, if in future it is necessary to replace this expert, that successor should also participate in this activity of capturing knowledge. This is just some kind of statistic across nuclear organization, which was done by Atomic Energy Agency a couple years ago. And you can see that on the first position is at the bottom, it's employee interview. And interview can be just for capturing knowledge during working of expert. And sometimes, and it's very important, it is necessary to organize so-called exit interview when person is leaving organization. Photo and video in my presentation, it will be on general umbrella of observation, also quite often used questionnaire and knowledge mapping. Percentage?
Yeah.
Just percentage? You mean that if you pull a summary is not 100, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, you. You're absolutely right. Just it's just average across many organizations and many countries.
Taking from the document.
Yes. Yes, it's taken. Ah, sorry, yeah, taken from document. There is document, I think it will be reference, methods and tools for preservation of knowledge. This special document, you will find quite a lot of information. Just common method to capture knowledge. Now, nine. I am talking only about nuclear organization and from practical point, because of course its list will be much, much longer, but my focus is nuclear area. Interview, this is top, unstructured, semi-structured, and structured. Knowledge organization systems, its course. It's mind map, concept map, 3D diagrams, and taxonomies. Concept mapping, it's very, very similar. Process mapping, also quite important because it's process for nuclear power plants in particular. Commentating, observations, a constraint task, it's very similar structured interview. Concept sorting, I mentioned already a little bit, and repertory grid. I will describe shortly each of them. First of all, of course, interview. Three main types of interview. Unstructured, semi-structured, and structured interview. I participated in many of them, and we found that most efficient way to organize interview with expert is semi-structured interview. It means it should be prepared some very valid questions. And after that, it should be some flexibility, freedom to ask additional, to clarify, or to give possibility of expert to describe more detail, maybe some logically related subjects. It is necessary to stress that most difficult part and very important, and to formulate and ask right questions. I already mentioned probably on in my first presentation that there is a special there is book learning to fly. It's Collins from British Petroleum. They described a lot of things very useful for knowledge management, in particular that it is necessary to learn before doing something, during doing something, and learn after that to improve after that performance and everything, and maybe modify. And most important things, what they stressed in their book, it's to formulate and find right questions. To formulate a right question, it is necessary to have another expert, which will be at least at the very similar level as expert which will be interviewed. Also quite important to use right terminology. We know when we ask some expert on nuclear power plants, what kind of explicit knowledge do you have? And it was polite answer, what? Because they don't know. They know what does it mean experience, what does it mean skills, what does it mean information, but they don't know what does it mean explicit or tacit knowledge. That is why when you are, and after that, dialogue could be not so friendly, not so open. That is why, and by the way, on each organization could be special terminology. And if you use this terminology, it means you can, as facilitator, you will be recognized as on the same level or a member of family of organization. If not, it will be barrier, resistance, and so on. It's definitely. Sometimes we discovered it in Ukraine, on South Ukrainian nuclear power plant, it is necessary even to invite psychologists. Because many of these methods was developed by psychologists, by the way. Mind mapping, concept mapping, some kind of this structured interview, this is developed by psychologists. And psychologists in Russia, there is on each nuclear power plant, for example. And during at least first interview, to remove barrier, to open person, expert, it would be very, very efficient way. Unfortunately, it's not each organization has such a possibility to involve psychologists, but if it's possible, do it. This is definitely very, very effective and efficient. Taxonomy, knowledge organization system and taxonomy and concept mapping. It's a visual way when you try to write a structured map of knowledge. Any kind of visualization, it's always quite efficient way of talking with any expert. Just example, this is concept map which described knowledge management. Some concept from what main element around this concept of knowledge management has, what is semantic links to other concept. Another example, it's taxonomy of our VVR reactor, which is main reactor in Russia, just structure. This is a huge file, and you can use it for a creation of some manual technical documents, because after creation of this or developing this structure, you can check what kind of documentation you have for particular concept, for particular subject, what is missing. Also, we developed these templates for interview for experts in Smolensk nuclear power plants, and you can see this is just we used even color, and we ask expert know whom, with whom he contact, what kind of risk in his job, what main functions of his position, which kind of technical documentation he or she is responsible to maintain, and what kind of technical documentation is used, and so on. And after that, developing this map, we can, with color, for example, red, identify position where knowledge are unique, or where knowledge even critical. This is some things to consider, that this is a good tool for visualization of information. This is definitely could be used as first step to identify knowledge, maybe even to put with color some priority, and after that next step, it can be already done in the direction of capturing knowledge. And of course, there are a lot of IT tools how to help. I know before, because we started use this tool in 86. It's first time, and we did it on paper, but it could be done on paper. It's not a problem. Okay, process modeling, it's very important, because when you write process, because people, when he expert is doing something, of course he is doing in time. That is why there are some phases, and quite important to write process. And we had very good example in some engineering organization in Russia who is responsible for produce some equipment for nuclear power plants, for example, steam generator. We asked expert to describe process of developing something, and immediately during description it was visible how to modify this procedure, how to reduce number of steps, and they did it, and they save a lot of time. This is just as example, quality control, but not necessary. Even we could write procedure of capturing knowledge or other things. This is very easy. Commentating. What does it mean, commentating? It means expert himself watch how another person doing something, who will replace him, and do some comments about his job, his activity. This is quite efficient way, because when part of knowledge and experience already transferred, it's not. It's very difficult to understand whether it's enough or not enough. And when a person already start doing by himself or by herself job, expert can watch and do provide some comments. Observation. Observation, it's technique now, it's very, very more and more often is used. We can use up to date technology, IT, video recording, just to save time. When expert is doing something, just observe, do some recording, voice, video, and after that put in knowledge base. Constraint task, I said already, this is kind of unstructured or structured interview when they prepared some list. And by the way, I will put for you in additional material on CLP4.net example of this questionnaire before interview, when expert can answer some question, and after that it would be much easier to formulate right question for next interview with expert. This constraint task, it's quiz, assessment questionnaire, and so on. Concept sorting. I already said to you, I described that that we did it in my organization when it was necessary to identify people owner of critical knowledge. Because sometimes even it is necessary to stress person critical with critical knowledge in the division could not be critical at the level of organization. And person with critical knowledge at the organization cannot be critical at the level of corporation. What is in Russia? We have huge organizations. That is why it's always with high level of probability we can find if necessary somebody who can replace if it's necessary. And just this is photo of our school, NKM school, when it was special exercises, knowledge market. It was when people also use concept sorting with card sorting, and they, this is just demonstrate for you that we used even at the school this methodology. Repertory grid, I think we know everybody use it in our life. When we go to shop, we create some list, what is necessary to buy. Sometimes when we think what to buy, car or TV or some expensive other equipment, we are thinking about properties different, about cost, about maintenance, about guarantee, and so on. This is just a repertory grid. This is example of, and it, you can find also in the book of method and tools for preservation of knowledge. This is a list of procedures, processes of knowledge preservation. This is some IT tools, database, portals, and after that, expert can identify which tools is most efficient for concrete process. Another example, when from nuclear area, when you should select flow meter device, you can put some property. This is different types of this equipment. This is property. Put some ranking. For example, if it's cheap, highest ranking. If it's very expensive, low rating. And other property. After that, you can find summary and select most adequate or pragmatic one for your organization. Conclusion. This is obvious that there is quite wide set of technique and method how to capture tacit knowledge, how to work with expert and experts. And each organization, each people should select most efficient one, because even it depends on generation, because young people prefer computer, old people prefer paper, and on structured form they ask another expert. Some people, even it depends on nationality, because, for example, card sorting, it's very, very popular in UK. But, for example, in other countries, maybe they even don't know about such method. We should also understand that volume of information, what we are capturing, is not equal quality. Because it's not easy, because it's very easy to say, but it's not easy in practical to understand what does it mean. And process of capturing knowledge, tacit knowledge, is not one step process. It's multi-step process. You should start, you should be very, very delicate with experts, because they are very busy, they are clever, and their time is very, very expensive. Prepare, repeat several times, and after that you will be successful. And focus, of course, on critical knowledge based on result of risk assessment. This is a very good tool which was developed by agency, and I recommended it very much to you. Thank you very much for your attention.